Stanford University.
If you change the way
this course succeeds in part because it reignites, or ignites in the first place, the energy that comes from the joy of making things. They have time to fail, learn, try again, do a little better, learn some more, try again, and finally deliver something in which they will be proud.
I made a table that I call the Starburst table. It's a cast aluminum top with a walnut base. I really like mid-century design, and so that was a lot of my inspiration for the table. I learned a lot about the manufacturing process. I never spent any time in the machine shop before or the foundry. I just never thought that I would be able to design something and actually produce it. So I think that's why this class meant so much to me.
I made a rocking forearm crutch. I've rounded the bottom. We don't walk on pegs, so it makes sense that a crutch would move forwards with you when you walk. I took a class last quarter called The Biomechanics of Motion, and it was really neat for me to use what I had learned in a bioengineering class in a mechanical engineering class.
They really have to learn to dance with their materials rather than fighting with them, because the materials will win every time if you try and go into a boxing match. But a little waltz, and the chances are that you get some of the exquisite creations you see out here today.
I made the Ema teapot, and I was interested in making a teapot because I find that tea is a way that I can help slow down my day. I wanted to design something that was modern and not too gaudy and frilly and floral, but also just really simple and warm. A lot of handles kind of come up and over, or comes like Japanese teapots, they come straight out of the teapot. So I think the handle is probably my favorite part, and it feels really nice in the hand. It feels really sturdy.
ME203 transforms the lives of its students, giving them the agency and the confidence that they can go into the world and actually modify materials to create things to change the world.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.